morning and welcome to worship this morning. Every time I come in, I know we can count on one thing, it's great music. Thank you again for what you provide for us. Do we have any announcements this morning? Yes.
What's the name of that song?
Thy Word.
It's a lovely song.
Mm-hmm. Amy Grant.
She did a good job with that one. Still good.
We have been getting the donations for the Black String Triage Ensemble. That is our mission for the month of July. Thank you for bringing in your gift cards and your money. It goes for gas and fast food places or food places for the musicians that volunteer their time. And there's information out there on the table, and there's a receptacle for the gift cards. Next week is the last Sunday that we will be collecting that. And we continue with collecting the laundry detergent for Reformation Milwaukee. So the cart is empty now, so you can still bring some in because that's an ongoing.
Any other announcements this morning? Speaking of ongoing, I will continue to make trips down there with the items that you all bring. So if you bring it to the basket, I'll get it the rest of the way. So, and they definitely need laundry detergent. That's something that's high on the list right now. So, and it doesn't matter if you get it at the dollar store, Sam's Club, or wherever. They just, when I was there dropping off the lunches a few weeks ago, I was reminded of that need right now. So, let us stand for our opening hymn. God of our Lord, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the grace of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
This time will you join me as we pray the prayer of the day. Almighty and ever-loving God, you are always ready to hear, then we are to pray. And you glorify and honor, and we desire, or deserve. pour upon us abundant mercy. Forgive us those things that weigh on our conscience, and give us those good things that only through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Lord. Amen. You may be seated.
Now he was casting out a demon that was mute. When the demon had gone out, the one who had been mute spoke, and the crowds were amazed. But some of them said, "He casts out demons by Beelzebul, the ruler of the demons." Others, to test him, kept demanding from him a sign from heaven. But he knew what they were thinking, and he said to them, "Every kingdom divided against itself becomes a desert. House falls on house. If Satan is also divided against himself, how will his kingdom stand? For you say that I cast out demons by Beelzebul. Now if I cast out demons by Beelzebul, by whom will your exorcist cast them out? Therefore, they will be your judges. But if it is by the finger of God that I cast out the demons, then the kingdom of God has come to you. When a strong man, fully armed, guards his castle, his property is safe. But when one stronger than he attacks him and overpowers him, he takes away his armor, in which he trusted, and divides his plunder. Whoever is not with me is against me, and whoever does not gather with me scatters." The word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Let us bow our heads for a moment of prayer this morning. Precious Lord, we as Christians sometimes get divided among ourselves. And sometimes we get divided and we lose our path of staying connected with you. But Lord, one of those ways that we can always reconnect and stay connected with you is through prayer. We ask you this morning, Lord, to continue to strengthen our opportunities for prayer, to strengthen us as praying people, and to let us never forget the power of prayer. Amen. There's a lot in this particular piece of gospel this morning, but I want to highlight a couple things. The first one is, every kingdom divided against itself becomes a desert, and a house falls on the house. And the last verse, "Whosoever is not with me is against me, and whosoever does not gather with me scatters." So the focus of my time with you this morning is, what can we do to be closer to God and to prevent ourselves from being divided as a community of believers. This again is a great piece of scripture for a church that's about to start in the process of putting together a ministry site profile, because this church has been down this road before. Sometimes we can get in a situation of just disagreeing with each other to the extent that it takes away the purpose of what we started out doing. Have you ever been on a committee where it started out pretty clear, and then by the time you got your report done, you got everything turned in, it just seemed like everybody else in the church was against what your decision was? And it was like, oh my God, where is this coming from? I don't, this pushback, whoa, wait a minute. That's what this scripture is talking about, being divided. A divided house cannot stand. After 25 years in parish ministry, what I would say clearly I put this right up there with not having enough money. If a church is divided, it's not going to be able to stand. It's certainly not going to be able to call a new pastor. I'm not saying that we are divided here at all, but I'm saying we're about to engage in the process of the mission exploration team, and that team is going to be called upon, challenged, questioned, and you begin to second doubt yourself. Now, Jesus had a job to do, to get cast out these demons. And people probably looked at Jesus cross-eyed and said, I don't know if he can really do this. This is a pretty big task. This is not like going to the doctor with a cold. This is going to someone who is possessed with demons. And in the Catholic Church, they have a process called an exorcism, an exorcist who, some people, they have whatever it is in their mind and body that is just controlling them. But I remind you also of the power of prayer this morning. This is where I'm going with this scripture this morning, is the power of prayer. The man that came to get healed was not able to talk. He was the mute. But I'm thinking in my mind that probably one of the first things that the man did once the demons were casted out, he was able to talk. He was able to say what he wanted to say and say what was on his mind. I'm thinking that one of the first things he did was engage in some type of praying. Praying to God. Praying, saying, thank you, God, for letting Jesus heal me. And in that process, that can show the other people how important praying is. At some times in our lives, we face situations that are very, very difficult, and it looks like it's impossible to overcome the hurdle. Difficult and impossible at the same time. One of those situations usually is around health. But another place where that happens is in the church, and usually in the church around moving forward. Moving forward is not at all easy for a church. But praying through a situation and reminding yourself that you are on a journey that's going to require prayer is going to help all of us involved to get to that next level. On Sunday morning when I'm there and I encourage people to pray out loud, one of the reasons why I do that is because praying out loud gives us an opportunity to see the power of prayer in community. I can't say that enough. The power of prayer in a community. We have the community. Now, all we have to do is just remind ourselves how important it is for us to be praying together. And I'm not saying we need to start praying out loud together on Sunday mornings. I'm not saying that at all. But I am saying there's some power in that, knowing that people are praying for you. When I've had the opportunities, and there hasn't been many, to visit your sick and shut-in people, when we, Mary Ann and I, let people know that the church is praying for them, you can just look in their faces and tell how happy they are about that. That's something that's so easy to do, to say a prayer for someone. When you think of someone, say a prayer for them. One of the things that the Synod does is prays for all the churches in this Synod, and there's a lot. But because I'm here and I'm able to communicate with them, I'm telling them our process. So they're praying as we about to start our process for the mission exploration team. They're praying just for that. On Wednesday mornings, between 9 and 12, they have a staff meeting. But a part of that staff meeting that the synodical staff does is spend time praying for the people in the churches in our synod. And that's very important because we need all the prayer we can get. And when I was a kid, I heard it early and I heard it often. I would face a situation, or my grandmother or my mother would be facing a situation, And you all have probably heard it. You don't stand a prayer. You don't stand a prayer getting through that. But you know what? That man in this story knew that Jesus could heal him and cast out the demons. And praying, we have to have no doubt that prayer works. We have to have no doubt that praying is one of the things that we want to teach to our young people. And yes, I still pray in public when I go out to eat, and I'm black, so I don't, I mean, you get used to people staring or looking. And so but to have another reason for someone to stare at you or look at, it's like when I put my hands like this and I'm out and my wife and I or our daughter or our kids are praying. I tell you, it's one of the best feelings around. Because often they'll say, can you say a prayer for me? You must be a praying person. And I said, of course I can. Of course I can. I remember my wife and I, this was a few weeks ago, we went to some program downtown. We got some tickets for that. And I had the collar on. I just left church here, and I had to run home to get her and go all the way downtown. And from here all the way downtown, it was like 3rd and Wells. It's a little hike to do it and get there safely. And so I got out the car, and the person parking the car said, can you pray with me before you go in? She had just lost her daughter last night in an automobile accident. And I said, sure. I mean, I was already late anyway. I mean, you're already late. So, but she knew the power of prayer, and she was wondering if I believed in that enough to stop what I was doing and have prayers with her. And I did. And that reminded me, it was good for me, probably better for me than for her, because I'm the one that had the collar. I'm the one that went to seminary. I'm the one that should be saying, you know, wow. For a minute, I was saying, like, I really don't have time for this. I'm just thinking in my mind. That was like a fleeting thought. Think about that the next time you don't have time for prayer, or you think that it doesn't really matter. As we, as a congregation, continue on this transitional journey, I say to you this morning that I'm going to continue to lift up on a regular basis, not every Sunday, but over the time that I'm here, the importance of community prayer, the importance of all of us praying together for our future, praying together for whoever that new pastor is going to be. And that means that when you are out doing something or on a trip or wherever you are, just taking a minute to say, I think I'm going to say a prayer for the church. I think I'm going to say a prayer for Pastor Ron. I think I'm going to say a prayer for our mission exploration team. Praying and the power of prayer, and knowing that all of us are coming together because we believe in that. The man that needed to have the demons lifted out that morning, that day, whatever time that was when he came and said he needed that done, he had to have enough faith that that would be done, that he would be healed. And he did. And I'm just thinking, I didn't read all the way through this particular passage, but I'm thinking that one of the things he did when he had his voice back, because our gospel tells us that he could talk, was to pray. Praying, praying, praying makes a difference in how we do our lives, how we live our lives, and our congregation, how we move forward with the power of prayer. Amen. Let us stand for our Be seated. Let us prepare our minds and hearts this morning for our prayers of the community, for the community, both the community within and the community without. Do we have prayer concerns this morning that you'd like to lift up out loud? Lord, this morning you've heard our concerns, and Lord, you know what's on our minds and in our hearts. I would ask you, Lord, this morning to continue to circle this community, circle our building with your presence, to continue to give us the courage we need, Lord, to move forward, to continue to give us not just the courage, but the conviction that we will need. Not just the courage and the conviction, but the commitment that we will need as we move ahead to answer your call to serve at this location. And Lord, we thank you for all the ways that you continue to bless this congregation, both financially and also with members. And we know well, Lord, that where one or more are gathered, your work is being done. Your work is being carried out as we continue forward on this journey. Let each and every one of us not forget the power of prayer and not forget to bring our concerns to you, Lord. What trials and tribulations, Lord, are we carrying right now that we need to be bringing to you? What fears do we have right now
that we need to be bringing to you, Lord. As we look around our country, we see so much torn apart. And yet, Lord, you have kept your church doors open through COVID, through a lot of other situations, and you've kept these doors open for us to answer your call. And we thank you, Lord, for giving us that opportunity to do that here at Reformation Lutheran Church. Amen. Please join me as we pray this morning. We pray. Sorry about that, I got the wrong page here. On that night, our Lord and Savior took bread, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after the meal, he took the cup and gave it for all to share, saying, "Take and drink, this cup is the new covenant in my blood shed for you and for all people. Do this for the remembrance of me." Let us say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Come. Our table is ready. the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, may the body and blood of our Lord and Jesus, Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen.
Please join me in our sending him. God of abundance, with this bread of life and cup of salvation, you have united us with Jesus Christ, making us one with all your people. Now send us forth in the power of your Holy Spirit, that we may practice your redeeming love, and the word will continue forever in the risen life of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Go in peace, serve the Lord.